Hey everybody, this is Jason Akers again with Green Acres Pest Control. And today I want to talk about diatomaceous earth, or DE for short. There's a lot of videos going around YouTube, including ones that I have done, on diatomaceous earth and how it is the end-all solution to pest control. And I'm going to address that today. I'm going to debunk that, and I'm going to explain to you who are watching this video that anyone who claims to use diatomaceous earth effectively on YouTube is a liar. And the reason, and that's a bold claim, but they are absolutely not telling you the truth. The problem with diatomaceous earth is that it is a dust. It is you should treat it as an insecticide dust, like 7-Dust. You know, the thing is that it is not healthy to breathe in a dust. If your home is dusty and you've got dust all over your furniture, the last thing you want to do is spread it around and breathe it in. It is not healthy. People take diatomaceous earth to an extreme. They spread it all over their carpets to kill fleas. They spread it all over their mattresses and their box springs to kill bed bugs. They spread it all over their kitchen to spread to kill cockroaches. This is not effective. Diatomaceous earth does not do an adequate job to kill any of these insects. Fleas, bed bugs, or cockroaches. It is not effective. The reason it is not effective, everyone likes to admit or claim that bed bugs, cockroaches, you know, basically bugs of any kind, have an exoskeleton that has to be punctured in order to die, which is true. This is true. Okay, so the way that an insect dies when you scar or mar its exoskeleton is okay, so human beings perspirate through their skin. Bugs don't perspirate. They don't sweat. So the way that you cause a bug to dehydrate is you have to scar its exoskeleton or make holes in it. So what happens is the holes allow for their bodily fluids to escape. They basically begin to sweat. They begin to dehydrate and dry up and die. Now, diatomaceous earth, can it do this? Yes. Can it kill bugs? Yes. The problem is that it does not kill the bug fast enough to stop its life cycle. In pest control, we learn, and this is something that you learn when you get a license, you learn that in order to kill a bug, you have to break its life cycle. You have to stop the cycle from basically egg to bug to reproduction to egg again. So just to make it simple. So what you do is you have to stop it from laying eggs, stop it from reproducing, kill the insect before it has offspring, because the offspring is what is going to continue to cause you a problem. Now, the issue with diatomaceous earth, while it does kill bugs, it does not kill them fast enough to break this life cycle. That's the issue. So when you see these videos on Facebook and on YouTube and on Twitter and all these social media platforms claiming that you can kill bed bugs for $5, you can kill cockroaches for $5, because a bag of DE is super cheap. It doesn't cost anything to purchase diatomaceous earth. It's really cheap. It's really affordable. People take it as a health supplement. They eat it, you know, they put it in their belly and it kills their parasites and stuff like that. I'm not saying that DE is a horrible thing altogether. I'm saying that as far as pest control, it is not effective. It is just not effective. Not only is it not effective, it's not safe. Okay? When you take a pest control product like DE or a you know, a pesticide. Okay, so here's my question to you. Do you want to put chemical all over your body? Do you want to breathe in a pesticide? Do you want it to go into your lungs? Is that something that you want to do to yourself? So if you answered no to that question, why would you want to put dust? Okay, it's a dust all around your house, and then breathe it in. All right, houses that are extremely dusty, they have dust particles in the air all the time. They tell you that you need to dust your belongings. Like if you've got dust that collects on your dressers, if you've got dust that collects on your table, if you've got dust that collects on your television, that you're supposed to clean that stuff up and get it out of your house and run your vacuum cleaner and get rid of the dust in your carpets and get rid of the dust on your chairs. And, you know, don't sit in the chair. The dust will poof up and you'll breathe it in because you need to get the dust out of your home. Dust is not good for your health. It's not good to breathe it in. Dust consists of skin cells, hair follicles, all kinds of things that are in dust and dirt and stuff that you really don't want to breathe in. So if you go and you add diatomaceous earth to the amount of dust that's in your property, you're going to end up breathing it into your lungs. You cannot avoid this. It is not something, it doesn't matter how lightly you apply it, you will end up inhaling dust. If it is in your living space, if it is around your person, if it is where you sleep, if it is where you cook, if it is where you walk through your carpets and your floors. A lot of people use diatomaceous earth for fleas because they have little ones, like a baby or a puppy or a cat or something, and they're worried that if they put pesticides in their carpet that they are going to harm their children or their pets. But then they take and put diatomaceous earth in their carpet that hurts their children and their pets. So a lot of people comment on my DE videos. They like to say, You just don't want people to buy a safe pesticide to use in their home because it takes from your business. This is YouTube, okay? I cannot work for anyone on YouTube. I cannot work for anyone on Facebook unless they're local to my area in Virginia. I am telling you these things because I don't want you to hurt yourself. I provide lots of free advice on my YouTube channel. I teach people how to kill bed bugs. I teach people how to kill cockroaches. I teach people how to kill fleas. I teach them the proper products to use and the proper safety measures to take to eliminate these issues. Fairly inexpensive. It's not about making money. It's about keeping you safe. If you go through my channel and read the comments on my diatomaceous earth videos, you will see people that have posted, "I wish I had, quote, I wish I had watched your videos sooner because now I have problems breathing." All right. "I have problems with my lung function now. I have been diagnosed with emphysema. I have issues with allergies. I have issues with asthma." These are problems that people have from using a dust haphazardly in their home. They don't know how to use it. They misapply it and they harm themselves, just like with any pesticide on the market. So you can go to the store. You can buy pesticides. You can go to Amazon. You can buy pesticides. If you bring them into your home and you misapply them, you can make yourself sick, okay? If you bring diatomaceous earth into your home, you can make yourself sick. You can harm yourself. It is not safe, okay? So hopefully I have really gotten the point across. I know that this is a video that's probably gonna upset a lot of people, but it is the truth. I'm not lying to you. I know a lot about how pesticides work and how dusts work on an insect and on a person. And I personally, as a pest control technician, I own my own company, I would never, ever go into someone's home and apply dust, no matter what kind of dust, no matter what kind of safety you know, label or whatever, food grade or whatever BS they put on the label to make you feel like it's safe for you to use. I would never put a dust in someone's carpets or on their furniture or in their house because it is toxic, okay? So hopefully this video has explained the dangers of diatomaceous earth and why you should not use it unless you really know what you're doing. You guys have a really great day. I really appreciate it. Give me a thumbs up if you like the video, and I'll see you later. Thanks.